Today's episode features some ultra glam looks in the most classic color ever, black. Let's see which all looks were on fire and who needs to fire their stylist right now.
We're also looking at some copies and we have a new segment where we discuss some Bollywood gossip.
So let's begin with this episode of Crush or Crash.
Okay, so starting with our first segment, which is the trending looks. So which first on the list is Radhika Apte. I love how she's serving that old Hollywood glam look, starting from that fully embellished gown with that, you know, nice V-neck and the fitted bodice, and you have those 3D motifs along with the sequin work all over the gown. So that's pretty interesting. And she paired up that beautiful black gown with those studded colorful gems necklace. And I think I like that contrast of color against the black. She went for a really tight and neat top knot bun. So that's a check for me. That winged eyeliner, that thick winged eyeliner, another check for me. And I love it. I love everything about this entire look.
I don't like anything about this look. I think nothing's working in her favor. If I have to keep elements separately, maybe. Her makeup looks nice. I'm not a big fan of the pink lip. Hair looks fine. Firstly, I don't like the gown personally. It's in three parts. I can see three different fabrics and three different techniques happening. The top half is sequin. As we go down to the bodice, still her knee is a self-embossed fabric and that goes into a fish cut. The bottom half is interesting, but I don't like the use of the three different fabrics here. Not a big fan of the fit. Don't know if the top knot's working for me. Then the winged eyeliner, as she said, it was giving a very retro Hollywood vibe. But it's not gelling. So I'm quite disappointed in this look. Like, her style is brilliant. So I'm so used to seeing her dressed to the point that this one's such a downer and I'm crashing it.
I am super crashing this. I don't know what's wrong.
Okay, so next on the list is Priyanka Chopra, actually PC. So Priyanka here is wearing a white pantsuit from Victoria Beckham that she styled with a black sheer mesh top, which has a band collar detail, which is solid black, which turns into a bow. And then she's gone for these PVC heels again with the bow detail on the shoe as well. And she styled it with diamond rings and diamond hoops, like the small ones. Lovely makeup. Now, what I like and what I don't like about the look. The fit of the pantsuit. Not very flattering. I just feel like it's not working in her favor. I like the way it's styled. It's interesting. But if you see the trouser, that overlap thing, it's giving such a weird fit to the trouser, especially when that area is visible. And you're wearing it under a tailored blazer. I think it just kind of looks a little odd. Also, the matching of the bow, wo thoda zyada ho gaya. Like, gale pe bhi bow hai, phir pairon pe bhi bows hai. For me, that's a little too much. I love the makeup. The makeup is spot on. I love the pop of color on that, on her eyes. And, you know, they finished it with like smoky black and like creating like a wing, like a cat eye, which is wonderful. I think the makeup is the most elegant thing about the look. And I love the combination of black and white. It looks very nice. Fit is very odd on her, which is making this entire look very sloppy.
I understand where they were trying to go with this look, the impact they were trying to achieve, but unfortunately the stylist did not sort of achieve in that zone. Because yeah, like she said, the fit is completely off. Like, the pants are quite stylish with that overlapping detail. But again, it's not working here with the tailored blazer. And I just feel like the mesh top underneath was quite unnecessary. Like, either they should have gone with a V-neck or something, because I really don't understand. And also, I don't like the bow detail because like the blazer is too close and you have a bow here, bow at your feet. Like, that's quite unnecessary. And the like the heels are Jimmy Choo, but not serving to that level, I would say. Not a fan. The eye makeup is definitely the saving grace here, no doubt about it. Love that winged eyeliner and that pop of color against the white, really nice. The hairstyle is just adding age to her face, I would say, and completely not working for me. She's wearing good branded clothes, she's wearing Victoria Beckham, but I'm sorry, please, it's not working for you this time.
I'm crashing it as well.
Crashing it. Okay, so next in the list is Vidya Balan. Like, I'm surprised to see her here. So she's wearing this really beautiful embroidered sari by Savan Gandhi. And yeah, so the outfit comprises of this embroidered sari, like the border is embroidered, like that zardozi work has been done, with this beautiful fully embroidered jacket to sort of, like, I'm really glad that she skipped a blouse this time. Like, this is something different. This is fresh, this is stylish. Like, she went for an Indo-Western look, and for her body type, this has been done so well. Like, it's accentuating the curves and it's looking really nice on her body, like sitting so well. So I really like that the embroidery has been done in a very neat manner and not like push kuch bhi bharti hai. So I really appreciate that. And the fact that she went for like really simple makeup with those like really nice cold eyes, that's about it. And she paired up the look with those earrings by House of Inaya, which I'm not a fan of. They could have gone with something more better.
Yeah,
like these are just like round studs, like bigger button wala earrings.
I just feel it's not like a blotch.
She's looking absolutely stunning and I'm super impressed with the choice of clothes this time and the entire styling. So yeah, a thumbs up for me.
Everything Vani said is absolutely correct. I think recently I've been seeing a lot of her looks and I'm very, very impressed. I think firstly, it suits her so much. It's so body flattering. Love the way they have done her makeup. It complements her so, like it complements the outfit really well. Like the idea of tying the hair and keeping it neat, as you can see that the neck is really high. There isn't much space here and the jacket is fully embroidered. We needed that breathing space. And they went for dark eyes, but they kept the makeup so minimal, so natural. It's beautiful and we both are crushing it. Okay, so next on the list is Kalki. This is one of the looks that she wore for promoting Sacred Games Season 2. So Kalki is wearing these separates from Rimzim Dadu. It's a black top and a silver skirt. It's looking stunning on Kalki. She's wearing it beautifully. I like how the styling is very minimal because the garment on its own is quite a statement. So I wouldn't overdo it because I want the garment to shine, right? So she styled it with these statement preto earrings, which are more like stud earrings in like a flower motif. Makeup wise, she's gone for bold lips, brown eyes, and that's about it. It's too little, but so much more to see. So I like that contrast in this look.
Kalki is wearing a Rimzim Dadu signature textile. And like she's acing it, I would say. I love the silhouette of the top. It's like just sitting like a, when you have those queens and kings, you know, have that kind of silhouette. I don't know, it's just giving me that vibe. Love that, love the skirt and you know that metallic finish that it has. Like just that right amount of bling and shine and that's about it. And yeah, I'm super excited to see this look. We both are absolutely like crushing
it. Now we start with our second segment, which is the I Spy segment. Shilpa Shetty and Hina Khan. Hina Khan, Shilpa Shetty is wearing this Banarasi sari gown by Amit Agarwal, which has been blatantly copied, but very badly copied. I don't like the original piece, firstly. Basically, it's Banarasi sari that has been deconstructed or draped to create a gown. It's a blue, royal blue sari with obviously the authentic Banarasi motifs. Coming to Hina Khan, it is even worse because they've chosen the similar sari, similar color, similar drape. But I mean, compared to Shilpa Shetty, it's even worse here because if you see jo sara ka sara motif ka kaam hai, it is in the bottom. And that border, which generally with a sari border, I'm not saying it's a stereotype, I just think the way the embroidery is, it should fall like this, right? It's supposed to be horizontal. But pura ka pura border vertical chal raha hai. Jo center mein hai, which is, I think it's just drawing very, like the attention to the wrong place. Technically, both of them are looking nice with their hair and makeup, stunning girls, but they both look horrible because the outfits are bad.
Okay, for me, I'm actually loving the Amit Agarwal sari gown in this case. I think Shilpa is looking absolutely stunning.
Mm-hmm.
And the entire look is quite spectacular. And I also love that she went for a pushed back, like back-combed hairstyle. So it's like a lioness mane and like quite big and poofy hairstyle. So I like the all-over impact that the outfit is giving and she's looking absolutely stunning. But coming to Hina Khan, oh my god, I don't want to talk about it because it looks cheap. Like from all directions, like the drape is off, I don't know if it's even a Banarasi sari or not, it just looks like a cheap Chandni Chowk version of the expensive gown, and it has been styled very badly because she went for opened hair, but like the strands are coming aage. I don't know why, because anyway, a lot of print and whatever is happening here. So Hina Khan's, we know that's a blatant copy, first of all, and it looks super cheap and super bad. And yeah, so I'm crashing Hina Khan and I'm super crashing Shilpa.
Crashing, obviously copy though even more, but crashing the entire thing. So guys, now we're finally on our third and final segment of the episode called Hashtag Got Candid. So this segment is all about gossip, scandals, Bollywood news that has been trending on social media and people are going crazy. So Vani and I will see how hot this news is, or is it too thanda for our hotness meter?
I'm so excited.
Lisa Hayden expecting the second child.
Yes.
Can I please swap lives?
Uh-huh.
I also want to look this stunning, yummy mummy to another level.
So it's really amazing to see that she found what she's actually into even after marriage and like having a kid. And when you get to do what you want to do, and I mean, that's what we live for, right? Like, she just kept it subtle and real, and that's what I like about her. She is who she is, and that's what she portrays herself on the social media. Mm. So I really appreciate that. I'm actually looking forward to that good-looking baby who's gonna like pop out of a belly. So yeah, super excited for that.
So definitely this is a pretty hot news.
Yay!
So that was it for the episode, guys. Let us know what you thought about this in the comment section below.
And while you do that, do not forget to check out the POPxo shop. We've got some really cool merchandise like planners, backpacks, fanny packs, mugs, and a lot more. So just click on the link in the description box and go shop now.
And for more styling tips and tricks and news on celebrity looks, keep watching POPxo Daily.